Welcome back, everyone, to Nagoya, Japan. Inside the Rainbow Ice Arena, the NHK Trophy continues now the final event of the regular season in the ISU Grand Prix of Figure Skating. And the original dance about to get underway. Let's check the overall Grand Prix standings right now. Born in Kratzev, Canada, with 21 points, along with Fusarpoli and Morgaglio of Italy. That's been a great rivalry to watch throughout the season. Drobiazko and Vanagas of Lithuania also. All three have earned spots in the Grand Prix final, so there are two remaining spots open, and there are four teams here in Japan trying to fight it out for those two spots. And here is one of those four teams still alive for the two remaining spots, Yelena Grushina and Ruslan Goncharov of Ukraine, the reigning champions of that country, had a great event at Skate Canada earlier in the series where they finished second. And Susie, this original dance, the second of three portions of the competition for the ice dancers after the compulsory dances. 3 minutes in length is the original dance, worth 30% of the overall score. And Grushina and Goncharov in fourth place right now.
One thing the judges are really looking for is great dancing. This year is the Latin rhythm. Vocal music is allowed, making it lots of fun. There are requirements within the original dance to make it easier to judge. Skaters and judges seem very comfortable this year with the rules. Elena and Ruslan are skating to a samba, so very animated, bouncy dance. The circular footwork, looking for interesting holds in the closed positions with lots of changes. Transition into rumba, slower rhythm, which demonstrate a sultry feel.
Both Yelena and Ruslan are from Odessa, Ukraine, but after the 96-97 season, they moved to the United States because their rink in Odessa closed down. They live and train in Newark, Delaware. Their coaches Natalia Linichuk and Gennady Karpinosov, the 1980 Olympic ice dancing gold medalist.
Pretty dance lift. Hard because he's on one foot through portion of it.
Of course, we saw that list of the overall Grand Prix standings just a moment ago, and Krylova and Ovsyannikov, the reigning world champs, not on that list because they have not competed all year long because of Angelika's back injury. Don't know whether or not they will skate this year at all.
Certainly would be a shame not to see them. They really add a lot to the event. They're really missing out a lot this season. Like about this team, they have great unison, they work well together. Could be that they're married, that doesn't hurt. Mm-hmm. But they really captured the spirit of the samba and the rumba. Very well done.
First medal in the Grand Prix series, back in Skate Canada where they finished second and still alive for the final. Yelena Grushina and Ruslan Goncharov of Ukraine.
Very smooth, they make everything look very effortless. This is a very pretty move. He breaks into a hydro blade, she's just resting on his leg. Very nice. One of their harder lifts, she shows great flexibility here, and notice here how he picks up his foot. Just a nice change of edge there for him. Good turns. They make it look easy.
There'll be two sets of marks, of course, the first for composition. And the range 5.0 to 5.2, very close together.
Well, I think skating first didn't help them in this case. I think the base mark should be a little higher. They skated it well, with authentic movement from the Latin rhythm dance.
And now the second set for presentation. 5.1 up to 5.3. Remember, the original dance were 30% of the overall score. So there are the marks for Grushina and Gonchalov of Ukraine. And up next,